Saichon, I just want to get a bit of perspective from you on the global market and how 2013 has been for Škoda and what 2014 is like. You've had a lot of new products coming out, so really a very key and exciting year for you despite some pretty tough times in Europe.
Yeah, 2013 has been a very demanding but finally very successful year for us. We are in the middle of the biggest product offensive ever we have seen in the history of Škoda. And last year we were busy in introducing the Rapid sedan to the European market and also to China. Then we added a second car last year, which is the Rapid Spaceback, which is a very important car for us. It's the first hatch in the compact segment in Europe. And it's a car which firstly has been introduced and positioned via design. And so far I can tell you the feedback was tremendous. And then the biggest deal we had to manage last year was, of course, the launch of the brand all new Octavia. So that started beginning of the year, European-wide. And then, of course, we also brought the Octavia to India with a huge success. And you must know, the Octavia is really the heart of the Škoda brand. It accounts for roughly 40% of the volume. It represents all Škoda brand values, like spacious, like simply clever functionality, good value for money, and of course, great performance. So therefore, this launch was very, very important. So far, the feedback is fantastic. The sales numbers are much better than we expected. And therefore, finally, we have managed to make 2013 very successful with record sales in Europe and record market shares in Europe. So very good year for us.
And coming to India, obviously, India has again been a challenging market. And you know, really, you're in a bit of a niche as far as volumes go. So what's your outlook on India? And clearly, I'm sure you would want a lot, many more volumes, and you want to be in more mainstream segments. And so are you studying the market and more opportunities here?
We had a very early market entry. We are here since 2001. We are very proud to be here. We built a strong image. We are producing cars in Aurangabad and in Pune, and we built up a very strong dealer network. So of course, right now, we are here, and volume-wise, what you have said, we are not on the volume segments, but right now we are very strong in the segments where we are. So the Octavia is a huge success. The Superb is positioned very well, yeah, and also with the Yeti, we found our positioning there. And of course, we are looking into the market very closely, and whenever there's an opportunity, of course, we'd like to expand our business. Yeah, and we know that 80% of the volume in India is where we are not right now, but we are deeply analyzing whenever we have the chance, we will be there, because India is and remains a very important and strategic market for Škoda.
Right. And you know, I want to touch upon the SUV space, which is really a hot segment in India. And I think Škoda also has got a lot of, is betting big on SUVs. I think clearly you've got a lot to show on the SUV space. I think your product portfolio in SUV is going to expand both above the Yeti and below the Yeti. I think it's no secret. So I just want to understand, obviously, SUV is quite a key segment for Škoda in the future.
It is. The SUV sector is developing very tough and very high. So we see a growth in all sectors of the markets. We, in the meantime, have 4 years experience with the Yeti, and that car is well positioned and well received by our customers. On top, Škoda has a very good experience in 4x4, so of course there is a chance for us to further grow that sector. So, and we are now analyzing whether there's a chance to build a bigger SUV, so we call it A+. Internally we are convinced to do it, but there is no final decision. But I hope that we can manage to add one. And of course, if the segment trend stays the same, of course we have to think about whether there's an opportunity below the Yeti. So therefore, of course, we are looking into that kind of opportunities because it fits 100% to our brand positioning.
Right. And just one last question. What's the toughest bit about the Indian market? Is it really the cost factor, that it's the margins you have to operate are very low, or the customer is very demanding, he wants a lot at a very small price? Is it the rupee weak? What are the main issues? Or really is it a cost issue, which is a real challenge?
Right now, it's the segmentation. Yeah, it's hindering it. Us a bit to expand our business, but on the other hand, we have to have the passion. As I said, we are convinced that the Indian market also for us provides a lot of opportunities, and I can tell you we will have the passion, and we analyze the market, and then we come up with some opportunities also here in India.
So by segmentation, you mean the segments which are big over here are very challenging and have got a lot of hurdles to get in?
In terms of car size and in terms of car prices.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.